Hong Kong has always had a very open and transparent financial system, well, in comparison to mainland China, just across the way. But that could be changing.
Yeah, it's an interesting story, this. I mean, Patricia's been looking a little bit more deeply than I have. But right now, people can access information about a company's directors through that public website you're looking at there. You do have to pay a small fee, but you can see their names, their addresses, and if you want to, their Hong Kong identification number. A lot of people have a very similar name, so the ID number is a key way of finding that you're actually looking for the right person. The government, though, wants to remove some of that information, they say, for privacy reasons, to protect some of these company directors. Many people are against it. They say it'll make it much harder to figure out who is involved with which company.
It's important for investors, banks and IPO sponsors to be able to determine what the other assets of a individual are, which companies he or she is a director of, and to be confident when they do that research that they're talking about the right person and not a mistaken identity. It basically undermines our reputation for free markets and transparency and the rule of law.
Certainly a big rights campaigner there, David Webb, here in Hong Kong. But you've been doing this, you've been looking at this more deeply, haven't you? And there is a march, and a lot of people have been petitioning against this.
Absolutely. I mean, not only financial companies who say it's going to be harder to do due diligence, but journalists, as you might imagine. You can see here in this morning's Apple Daily, this is a petition that has been signed by, I think, about 1,500 journalists. It's sponsored by Journalism Educators for Press Freedom and the Hong Kong Press Photographers Association. And basically, they are opposing this and saying that it's going to hinder investigative reporting. And
freedom of the press is such a sensitive issue here.
Especially as a former British colony, Hong Kong's used to having that.
Absolutely. And it's probably a coincidence that that just at the end of last year, we had a lot of reporting, international reporting, about the wealth, the alleged wealth of some of the families of the leadership of China. And now they're cracking down on actually finding out about who owns what companies. Maybe just a coincidence, but certainly it doesn't look good. Interesting timing.